Hi guys, Kushan Connect here. I'm coming to you today with an update on my Afghan and a couple of acquisitions from the last couple of weeks. So I guess I'll start with my Afghan since it's right here. I haven't really done a whole lot of work on it since the last time. I've been just really tired lately and not really in the mood to crochet. But I did manage to get the squares in between the circle motifs done. And I got one more circle motif done here. And I have another one almost done on the hook right now. And I think I forgot to mention last time exactly how many rows this Afghan is gonna be. So as you see here, I have two rows done and I am currently on the third row, and it's gonna be a total of, well, the pattern calls for a total of 5 rows of the circle motifs. But that's going to be a very short blanket. So I don't know if I'm going to want to keep going and add more, but that's going to take me so long. Each motif, well, it doesn't take me that long anymore because I kind of have the pattern down now. I still have to reference each step just to remind myself what each round is, but then I remember and I don't really have to look at the pattern that often anymore, but it still takes a while. So I don't know if I want to add any more or just leave it as the pattern calls for, because this is going to go to very tall people, so I don't know. I'll have to see how I feel by the time I finish the fifth row, so we'll see when that time comes. So that is the update on my blanket, and then over the last couple of weekends, my husband and I have gone to a bunch of thrift stores and a flea market, and I just picked up a couple of things. I have passed up on a lot of awesome yarn lately because I just have nowhere to store it now. So that's kind of sad. But last weekend, I did pick up a bag of buttons. I've always wanted to have, I was planning in my craft room to have a few jars of buttons, like organized by color, and like have like rainbow jar buttons on my cube shelves on the top there, but that's not gonna happen now because I don't have a craft room anymore because life happened. Not that I'm complaining, but I still do want to have a good stash of buttons, and there's always bags of buttons like this when I go to Value Village, but I never really found any that interested me. And then this one I just had to have because it has this little, I haven't opened it yet, but well, maybe I should open it now. So this whole bag of buttons was $3.99. I'll say that before I rip the tag off. But it came with this little zipper pouch of buttons. Oh, it hasn't even been opened. It still has the zip tag on the zipper, so you can't move the zipper. So it hasn't even been used yet. But yeah, I'm a sucker for cute little pouches. So I just had to have this, plus it's blue, which is my favorite color, blue and white. You can always use white buttons. And I've actually seen these somewhere. I don't remember where I've seen these, either Michael's or Walmart or something. And I always thought they were neat and I considered getting some, but I never did. And then I found one in this bag of buttons, so I had to have this. Plus, this bag has a lot of very large buttons. Just a lot of large, fun buttons, and I like putting really big buttons on crochet projects, so I wanted to have a few good large buttons. Plus, the other thing that made me really want this bag was these heart buttons, because that would be really cute for children's clothing, and I have two, well, one girl and one on the way. So, yeah, I don't know if I've mentioned it here yet, but this one that's coming is also a girl, or so they've told us. You never know, things could be hiding in the ultrasound, but they're usually pretty accurate with that kind of stuff, so we're expecting a girl. So yeah, so these buttons would be really cute for girl clothing, so I just had to have that. I do have a pattern for a button-up sweater that I considered making for my daughter when she was a baby, and I never got around to it. So if I do get around to it with this baby, I can use these buttons on it. And then there's also these shiny pink buttons, which would also be cute for later. And yeah, there's just a whole bunch of random, well, that one's kind of misshapen, but there's all kinds of really random neat buttons in here, so I just had to have this. I do have a couple of empty jars, so I probably will make one jar button at least and just keep it with my craft stash in the basement now. Ooh, square button. yeah, so bag of buttons, $3.99 from Value Village. There is that. And then also from Value Village, I picked up this book. It's called Crochet for Children because it actually is a book for children to learn to crochet, or for parents to teach their children to crochet from. So I thought, I'm trying really hard not to buy too many more craft books because I already have so many and limited storage space, but I just had to have this one because there's a lot of cute projects in here. So I figured it would be good to have on hand if either of my children ever want to learn to crochet, even if they don't. It would be good for me to have these patterns to make them things. There's a lot of really cute things in here, like toys and mittens and just a lot of cute small items, scarves. There's a lot of stuff in here. And it's like brand new condition. And Value Village has this like weird pricing system where their price for books depends on the book's original cover price. And so since this has a really high cover price, $24.95, they should have charged, I think it was $4 or $5.99 for this. So I was actually kind of hesitant to buy this because I thought that was kind of a bit much. But then my husband offered to pay for it, so I was like, all right. And then we had a stack of children's books that we bought for my daughter. And so the cashier just scanned this in as a children's book along with those children's books. So, and children's books cost $1.29, I think. So I got this for $1.29 instead of the like $5 it should have been. So that was fun. And then this past weekend, we went to a flea market and I managed to find a couple of really vintage issues of Crochet World magazine. This is the winter 1983 omnibook. I still haven't been able to find how many omnibooks they actually came out with. I have found a few lists of Crochet World magazine back issues on the internet, but they're incomplete, so I still don't know exactly how many of those there were. And they also had other specials that they came out with. I don't know how many specials. I have actually emailed Crochet World and asked them like for a list of all their back issues, and they responded and told me that no such list exists. I'm like, well, publishing company doesn't have some sort of record of all the things they published. But anyways, so they were no help. But anyway, I'm still going to try to collect as many as I can. And then I found the December 1985 issue of Crochet World. And it's so neat to see like how they changed through the years, because way back then, this is almost near the beginning of when they started, because they started, I think, in 78 or 79. So this is back near the beginning, and their magazines actually used to have like a lot of columns that they don't have now, like potpourri, which is people would write in and ask if anybody has specific patterns or if anybody would like pen pals, stuff like that. And there were like crochet help columns and like classified ads in the back. It's so weird, but it's so fun to read. So that's why I like the old issues. Plus there's some decent patterns in them too. And they were, as you can see, 50 cents each. I cannot take these price stickers off. I hate when they do this, but I can't take them off because I tried to take them off and they were like peeling the color off of the cover. So then I just left them because I don't want to ruin the covers. I hate when they do that. And I'm pretty sure all the magazines at this flea market booth were 50 cents. So they could have just had like a little sign instead of putting stickers on each magazine. I don't know why they do that. But anyways, so those are my few acquisitions. I did start recording the 10 non-crafty things about me tag, and then my camera died for some reason. It just shut off, and I don't know why. The memory card was empty before I started recording, so it wasn't a full memory card problem. And the battery was full, so it wasn't a battery problem. I don't know what's happening with my camera. But it is pretty old. It's like 8 years old now. It's just a little point and shoot that has video capability. So I definitely need a new camera soon. I'm thinking of maybe getting one if we get any money back from our income tax return. And I also have some birthday money that I haven't spent yet, so I'm considering getting a new camera soon, but I don't know. But yeah, so that the recording of that video failed. And I don't know if I feel like recording it again sometime this week. I don't know. I'll see. So that may come in the next week or so. And I hope to have another video up soon with significantly more progress on the blanket. And yeah, I think that's all I have to say for today. So I hope everybody's been having a good February and happy crafting.